Falcon Physics Democast by Steve Dickey from Divine Child High School. To find out more, check the Michigan Learning section of iTunes U, look in the high school section, or go to physics.divinechildhighschool.org.
Okay, so let's go with our classic elevator problem. So we have an elevator moving up at a constant velocity of 2.5 meters per second. So what's the first thing we need to do? Well, we need to draw our force diagram, right? So we, and again, anytime we do this, we do a force diagram. So we've got our down arrow, and we call this force gravite from the Earth on the passenger. Sure. Not so bad, right? Now, it says he is traveling at a constant velocity. Constant velocity means no acceleration, right? And then what else does it mean? It means balanced forces, because no acceleration means balanced forces, which means I should draw this one approximately the same length as this. I'll put a little tick mark on both so I know I've got equality marks. And what kind of force is it? Well, he's standing on a floor, right? That's a surface. So we have a normal force from the elevator on the passenger. Not so bad, right? And we know that those two are equal. So we want to calculate the force the floor exerts on the rider, right? So we know that the force of gravity will equal his mass times our gravitational field strength. And remembering, of course, that our gravitational field strength equals 10 newtons per kilogram. So that is mass times gravitational field strength, not milligrams. Now, we know his mass is 85 kilograms. So 85 times 10 is 850 newtons. Well, and what do we know about the length of these two arrows? Well, since we're moving at a constant velocity, the forces are balanced, meaning, of course, that the normal force from the elevator is also 850 newtons. All right. Not so bad, right? So, same as if he was not moving. Now, let's slide up a little bit here and look at the next problem. Now, we want to use the same elevator and the same passenger, and this time, the elevator is accelerating upwards. All right? So, what do we do? What? First thing we do is a force diagram again. As always, we draw a force diagram, and we toss our gravity arrow on there if we're on Earth. Not so bad, right? Force gravity from the Earth on the passenger. Now, we need an upward arrow. So let's see. He is accelerating upwards. So that would mean the forces are unbalanced. Not so bad. Now, how do we, what do we do now? Well, we, how do we handle this? Not so bad, really. What we do is we look at it and we say we're accelerating upward, which means we need to have a bigger force in the upward direction. So we know this arrow has to be longer than the gravity arrow. We're not quite sure how much longer yet, but that's okay. You'll notice no tick marks for equality. And again, this is the normal force from the elevator on the person. Now, how do we know it's not two forces pushing up? Well, there's only one thing that touching the person, right? Only the floor of the elevator touches the person. So that is the only contact force we can have. Quite often, we'll get to this and we'll go, oh, there's got to be an extra force pushing up. Well, in order for there to be an extra force, don't forget we need to name it, and we can't, if we can't name it, then we can't put it on there. Our first rule of forces again, right? All forces have an agent that is doing the acting and an object that is being acted upon. So in this case, our agent is the elevator, and the object is our person riding in the elevator, or our passenger. So now that we've realized it can only be one contact force and only one arrow, let's figure out how long these are. So how do we get force of gravity again? That's right. It's mass times gravitational field strength. So 85 kilograms times 10 newtons per kilogram means our force gravity is still 850 newtons. Wait, how could it be the same? He's being accelerated this time. Well, what's the name of this arrow? The name of this arrow is force of gravity from the Earth on the person. gravity from the earth on the person depends on the earth, and the earth didn't change, and the mass of the person didn't change, so therefore the force of gravity on the person didn't change, even though they are being accelerated. That means this arrow got longer, right? We already knew that. So how do we figure out how long this arrow is? Well, they give us a part of the answer here. First off, we need to figure out what the unbalanced force is, all right? We have two ways of finding an unbalanced force, right? Two ways. What? Well, which way do we use? Quite often, we'll have to use both. So it's not a matter of, oh, I like this way, so I'm always going to use this one. One way is we add our vectors, our forces up tip to tail, right? So remember, I can pick them up and move them. This is not a force diagram. And I can put this arrow here. This is my gravity arrow, right? And it's the same length. Remember, I can pick them up and move them all I want as long as I always keep them the same length and point them in the same direction. And then I can pick up my other arrow and I can lay it on top of this one. I'm going to put it next to it so you guys can see it. And this is my normal force arrow, right? Well, you'll notice it's a bit longer, isn't it? So this is my normal force. So force normal from the elevator on the person. Not so bad. Now, where is our unbalanced force? Where did we start? Right here. And where did we end? So we go dot, 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 dot. We do a dotted line. And there's my unbalanced force. So the green arrow is my force unbalanced. Now, you'll notice there's no agent object here. Because the unbalanced force is not actually a force. There is no object pushing an unbalanced force, right? So quite often, students get to this and they go, oh, which one of these forces is the unbalanced one? Is it the gravity force or the normal force? Well, both the gravity and the normal force have an agent and object. So they cannot be the unbalanced force. Neither one of them can be, which is why we draw the unbalanced force with a dashed arrow rather than a solid arrow, because the dashed arrow is the answer. It's not the question. The red arrows here, my solid arrows, are the question. And the red arrows go on my force diagram. So this is one way, right? But we still don't have the number because we don't know how big the normal force arrow is. Our other way is using that relationship we derived in class, that acceleration equals the force unbalanced over the mass. All right? Now, so we know the acceleration and we know the mass, right? So we say 2.0 meters per second squared equals force unbalanced. Now, what was the mass? Oh, yeah, the mass was 850 newtons. What? No, the mass in newtons? That doesn't seem right. What are units for mass? Units for mass are kilograms. So 850 newtons is the weight, not the mass. So what was our mass again? Our mass was 85 kilograms. So we need to put 85 kilograms here, right? Not so bad. So then, where do we go from here? Well, we take and we simplify this expression, and we find that force unbalanced equals how much? Well, what's 85 times 2? That would be 170 newtons. Pretty cool. So, what do we know now? We know that force unbalanced equals 170 newtons. Pretty cool, eh? Well, now, so do I add that or do I subtract that from the 850? That's the question we get next, right? Well, don't think of adding and subtracting from the 850. Look back at your tip-to-tail diagram. There's a reason we made this tip-to-tail diagram, that we did our vector addition, if you want the nerd word. We know the down arrow is how long? The down arrow is 850, right? Well, the up arrow has to go from here all the way up to there. So how long is it to get from this point to this point? Well, this piece of this line is 850 and this piece is 170. So we just simply add those two together in this case. And that'll tell us the length of the normal force. So we know the force normal of the elevator on the person equals 850 plus 170, right? Because it's got to be this entire length. Not so bad, right? So what's 850 plus 170? 850 plus, or 800 plus 100 is 900. 50 plus 70 is 120. So 1,020 newtons. And which 20 newtons? In which direction does it push? Upwards. Not so bad, right? Okay. Okay, so let's work one more example of our elevator math. Now remember, this is the same passenger from the front, so we know the mass of the passenger, as they told us on the front, was 85 kilograms. So now we've reached the top of the building, and we come to a stop. Well, if we come to a stop, what kind of acceleration do we have? We have a downward acceleration, or a negative acceleration, right? Not so bad. So let's construct a force diagram. So we make our dot, and again, you all know how to do this, right? So we make a dot, and this arrow is force gravity from the Earth on the passenger. Not so bad, right? Now we need to make an up arrow. What do we know? We know how many things are touching the elevator passenger. We got the passenger over here. We'll draw the picture again. Woo! There it is, right? Only one thing, right? The cable doesn't touch the passenger. The wall of the elevator shaft doesn't touch the passenger. The ground level of the building doesn't touch the passenger. Only the elevator touches the passenger. So we get one contact force arrow, right? So what is that? It's going to be the normal force, right? Because it's a surface contact. So how do we do this? We know we have a downward acceleration, which means the up arrow has to be shorter, right, than the down arrow. Otherwise, we wouldn't have a downward acceleration. So we're going to call this force normal of the elevator on the person. Pretty cool. Now, this is where students then go like this, oh, I need to use this. So we're going to use our acceleration equals force unbalanced over M. Not so bad, right? And we know M is 85. Good. So we know 3.0 meters per second equals force unbalanced over 85. Not so bad, right? So force unbalanced equals what? What's 85 times 3? Well, 3 times 80 is 240, right? And 3 times 5 is 15. 240 plus 15 is 255 newtons. All right. So now you'll notice this is already in newtons. This is, again, another spot where students will often take this unbalanced force and they'll multiply it by 10 newtons per kilogram to convert into newtons again. If you're our force already, you don't need to calculate the gravitational force of a force. It's already a force. You don't need to convert it. It's not kilograms. It is force. Not so bad. So anyway, so where does this go, right? Does this make this arrow longer or this arrow shorter, right? Which one does it do? This is where we get confused. Many students will go ahead and make this arrow, the gravity arrow, longer than it was before. Is that what we should do? Well, what's the name of that downward arrow? The name of that downward arrow is the force of gravity from the Earth on the person. And how do we get the force of gravity from the Earth on the person? We take their mass and we multiply it by our gravitational field strength. So it is 85 kilograms times 10 newtons per kilogram again. No matter what the passenger is doing in the elevator, this downward arrow, if it has the same name, it has the same value of 850 newtons. Uh-oh, what kind of weird newton is that? Let's fix that. There we go. Newtons. All right. Now, not so bad. So how long is the upward arrow? Do we add or do we subtract? Well, what's the other way we have of finding an unbalanced force? We line the arrows up tip to tail. So we do our gravity arrow down. So force gravity from the Earth on the person. And then we go upwards. And again, I'm putting it next to it so that you can see it, but you can put it on top. And then this is force normal from the elevator on the person. And then we need our unbalanced force. Where did we start? We started here, right? And where did we end? We ended down here. So we go doot, 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 doot. You need the dooting sounds, otherwise you can't make the unbalanced force arrow. And so our green arrow now is our force unbalanced. Right? Not so bad. So we know the force unbalanced equals what? We just calculated that. 255 newtons. And our gravity arrow equals, need the right pen. Gravity arrows equals 850 newtons. So this one is shorter than 850, right? So this time, we take away the unbalanced force to get our normal force. Not so bad. So first, when you're doing elevator problems, you need to draw your force diagram. You need to decide whether you're accelerating. And if you're accelerating, you need to have unbalanced forces. And then it's a matter of deciding which direction is the unbalanced force, right? And then you go slowly through the problem. You calculate your gravity force using our relationship of mass times the gravitational field strength, which is 10 newtons per kilogram. And then you do your vector addition to find your normal force. Not so bad.